Today's topic is probability of dependent events. Two events, A and B, are dependent if the outcome of the first event A affects the outcome of the second event B. This is the formula for finding the probability of two dependent events A and B. The probability of A and B is equal to the probability of A times the probability of B after A. The formula can be written as follows. The probability of A and B is equal to the probability of A times the probability of B given that A has occurred. Example number one. A box contains 8 red apples and 7 green apples. One apple is taken at random from the box and is not replaced. Then another is taken. What is the probability that the first apple taken is red and the second is green? Let us first find the number of apples. 8 plus 7 is equal to 15. So the total number of apples is 15. There are two events in the problem. The first event is taking a red apple from the box, and the second event is taking a green apple from the box. Let us represent the first event of taking a red apple from the box by R. The probability of R is equal to the number of red apples divided by the total number of apples. There are 8 red apples and the total number of apples is equal to 15. So the probability of R is equal to 8 over 15. Let us represent the second event of taking a green apple from the box by G. After the first event of taking a red apple from the box as a card, and the one apple taken at random from the box is not replaced, the total number of apples in the box is lessened by 1. So instead of 15 apples, there are now only 14 apples in the box. But the number of green apples is still equal to 7. So the probability of G, given that R as a card, is equal to 7 over 14 or 1 over 2. The two events are dependent events because the second event of taking a green apple from the box is affected by the first event of taking a red apple from the box. The formula we are going to use is the probability of R and G is equal to the probability of R times the probability of G given that R as a card. The probability of R is equal to 8 over 15 and the probability of G given that R as a card is 1 over 2. So this is now equal to 8 over 15 times 1 over 2. Cancel 8 with the 2. So 1, 4. 4 times 1 is 4. 15 times 1 is 15. So this is now equal to 4 over 15. So the probability that the first apple taken is red and the second is green is equal to 4 over 15. Example number 2. A box contains 3 red ribbons, 5 yellow ribbons, and 7 green ribbons. One ribbon is chosen at random and is not replaced. Then another ribbon is chosen. What is the probability that the first ribbon is yellow and the second ribbon is also yellow? Let us first find the total number of ribbons. 3 plus 5 plus 7 is equal to 15. So the total number of ribbons is equal to 15. There are two events in the problem. The first event is choosing a yellow ribbon. And the second event is choosing also a yellow ribbon. Let us represent the first event of choosing a yellow ribbon by y sub 1. The probability of y sub 1 is equal to the number of yellow ribbons divided by the total number of ribbons. There are 5 yellow ribbons and the total number of ribbons is equal to 15. So the probability of y sub 1 is equal to 5 over 15 or 1/3. Let us represent the second event of choosing also a yellow ribbon by y sub 2. After the first event of choosing a yellow ribbon as a card and the one ribbon chosen at random is not replaced, the number of yellow ribbons is lessened by 1. So there are only now 4 yellow ribbons, and the total number of ribbons, instead of 15, the total number of ribbons is now equal to 14. So the probability of y sub 2, given that y sub 1 as a card, is 4 over 14 or 2 over 7. The two events are dependent events because the second event of choosing also a yellow ribbon is affected by the first event of choosing a yellow ribbon. The formula we are going to use is the probability of y sub 1 and y sub 2 is equal to the probability of y sub 1 times the probability of y sub 2 given that y sub 1 as a card. The probability of y sub 1 is equal to 1/3, and the probability of y sub 2 given that y sub 1 as a card is equal to 2 over 7. So this is now equal to 1/3 times 2 over 7, and this is equal to 2 over 21. So the probability that the first ribbon is yellow and the second ribbon is also yellow is equal to 2 over 21.